Welcome back, guys. We are jumping into our third and final map. One of these teams will be going home after this conclusion. One will progress to later today, where they'll play another best of three. I'm not sure where Dust is. I think he went to get some food quickly, obviously. We're doing a lot of casting, so he'll probably pop up in a few moments' time. But I'll be taking you solo until then. We should be starting any second now. Renegade's going to be on the CT side, Fnatic on the T side. Of course, on Inferno CT side, certainly the preferable role. But after Inferno's had a few changes over the last few years, and I feel like it is way more balanced than it used to be. Still certainly CT side, but I think Fnatic can get a lot of rounds here if they start well. But obviously, we're going to have to wait and find out once this game gets started. The players are just readying up now, which is great news, and we'll be jumping into the pistol round. Ah, so apparently they're going to be doing the knife round. So I thought that had already happened. So in that case, we're going to have to find out who does the knife round first to elect which side will be which. Obviously, the winner will want to go on the CT side of things. If you did miss the earlier maps, map number one was Mirage. Renegades won it 16-14, a very close nail-biting map in the end, a map that both teams are proficient on, and then map two went the way of Fnatic. It was close in parts, actually, towards half-time, was very close indeed, and then on the CT side, Fnatic just started to take it away, as we kind of thought would be the case. Renegades, I can tell you, have just won the knife round. They're likely going to be electing to stay on the CT side. I'd be very surprised if they don't. And we should be getting things underway momentarily. This is where I'd love to ask you questions, but I think that there is actually a delay. So I was going to say, well, I'll say it anyway. I'll keep an eye on the chat. Where do you think this is coming down? Give me a vote, Fnatic or Renegades. Do you think Fnatic can do the reverse sweep and come back from the 0-1? Or do you think the boys are going to convert and play later? I think it's the loser of the other matchup that's also going on, which is NRG and G2 is out, and the winner will play against the winner of this game. Currently, indeed. Oh, Dust is back. Okay, cool. Indeed. So currently it's 1-1.
The weird thing was, is I came in, you were asking questions, and I was like, does he know I'm here? And he's asking me these questions, or like if you were being rhetorical. It's kind of crazy.
No, I was asking chat because,
okay.
Yeah, I was alone, all alone in this cold world, Dust.
Not anymore, Vince. I'm here to give you a comfortable pat on the shoulder.
To warm me up? Is that what you were going to say?
Yeah, that too.
Nice.
We're on a great battleground. Both these teams have played this map about an equal amount and have kind of similar results, so that actually should make for a great game here. Looks like Renegades are going to be around the CT side.
Yes. Obviously, with the third map, they do knife besides. Renegades won it. They elected to stay on the CT side. And we will be having a look to see how things shape up. It's going to be a four-player stack on A from Renegades. It's only JKS that is playing B site by his lonesome. Bomb now starting to make up. Through mid, Liaz is here alongside Jacob. They're trying to play possum there and bait them out into the open. It has worked so successfully, though, for Renegades. This crossfire locked down. There was nothing really preceding the push. It was just a case of being caught from two separate angles. JW's made a move into pit, though, which could catch the CTs off guard. No one's actually over there checking the angle out. But the bomb carrier, Broland, still needs to get through apps. I don't think they have any idea this has happened. Judging from where they're looking.
They're going to find out soon enough, though. JKS does spot JW going for the peak, so now everything's on the table. They know what they're up against, but can Brolin and company really brute force their way through? JKS is having none of it, it looks like, here, as he's going to tap them both out with a couple of headshots, rotating over from B. Liaz and Grass Factions with the normal A defenders coming up big on the pistol round, Vince. Only one Fragment Fnatic's way there.
Yeah, a bit of a miscalculation going through mid. Without any information and no nades, nothing really to supplement the push. Four UMPs and an M4. Of course, UMP is a jack of all trades gun. You can easily take that through into the actual full rifle rounds as well, no problem. So I quite like this. It supplements the potential to repel a force buy from Fnatic, but also if it does turn out that they're on an eco, as they are, it's still absolutely fine and will shred you a bunch of money.
So the full save here from Fnatic, didn't even get a bomb plant in the last round, but still don't want to force here. Want to get a nice full buy. This is a map where you don't really need the AWP on T side as much, right? A lot more favored for just five rifle setups. So that means that you can still get a pretty solid buy in round three on this map if you full save.
Long range tapping with the UMP. We'll see JKS and Jacob locking it down with three frags between the two of them. And Ash is going to finalize with his UMP. So money in the bank, but also they don't have to even upgrade any of these guns because the UMP is just fine against the AKs. Obviously, they're going to be coming through into this round, Dust, with a little bit of lower firepower, but UMPs still work wonders.
Yeah, now I want to see what Brolin can do over here on the banana side. He's the guy playing banana control a lot for Fnatic. He played apartments in the past on Red Reserve, so he might do some of that as well, to be honest. But it looks like Fnatic don't want to play default. They want to just go for something very fast-paced over towards middle and apartments. You see Brolin normally be here with Krims already. JW and company behind the smoke. They want to maybe pop flash through this or just as soon as it fades attack. But look at this. As Elias, Gratisfaction, Jacob, four players playing towards top mid for Renegades. This is going to be a blender that they get run through on the Fnatic side.
Yeah, very reminiscent to the pistol round. And are they going to just go and try again? Yes, they do. Now that they have at least quelled Jacob's positioning, it's doable, but with the boost up on Liaz, it's so painful. Flashbang in the eyes as well. Renegades off to a blistering start. Broland's been spotted in pit by JKS. Molotov gonna greet him. He's gonna have to walk over a floor made of fire to clutch this round out. Bomb's also in mid. So, I mean, he is just gone. Broland surely cannot get anything to stick in this. It should be Renegades taking a 3-0, barring a miracle play.
Players are low on health, but so is Roland's the problem, so he can't really take an engaged fight. And JKS will just finish it off before he even has a chance to take a crack at anything. And so it's 3-0 for Renegades. Such an aggressive forward positioning from them on top middle. A lot of teams just kind of give that up and then fight from Moto and Sight and Pit, but Renegades hold forward with a boost on Porch and absolutely just destroyed them.
You have to think that in future rounds, they are going to throw a couple of flashbangs at the very least before they try and push mid, because this is an absolute nightmare. They've run into twice. Grenade out of apps does land by the feet of Crimson JW. It's four players on A again. They have so much confidence in JKS holding banana by himself, and again it's going to be a mid push. This time there is a flashbang over. This time we are seeing grenades fire onto arches, but Jacob with his AUG is just holding on hard. He has no problem spraying through multiple oncomers. Bron again is the last player alive, purely off the basis that he went up. If he went through mid, he would have followed the rest of his team into an early death. Renegades 4-0 up already.
Yeah, Jacob just being that rotator from B, like you said, trusting in JKS to hold B alone and adding in the firepower on the arch wrap dominates them. But that was kind of one of those foregone conclusion rounds. You know what's going to happen. There's not much there. This is the buy from Fnatic that really matters. Will they slow it down and actually try to go for, you know, more banana control, do something a little bit more standard, actually try to leave options open rather than just committing so heavily towards mid so fast? But look at this, the aggression's at different locations now. Apartments, look at Liaz and Gratisfaction. They're so deep into the apartments now. Will Fnatic really expect this?
It is unlikely, but it doesn't seem like it may end up being an issue if they do continue to press forward on the B side. The bomb is there. Gratisfaction up close, though, could land himself a frag onto Broland. Oh, but no, there's two players there. Liaz is going to help him out. They got Boiler and also Longside off the app. Going to pull back. As soon as those two players are spotted, though, they instantly pick up the bomb and say, okay, let's go B. Let's mix this up. Jacob, though, perforates the smoke. Azar elsewhere onto Gratisfaction. And Fnatic just can't buy a round. Nothing is going their way. They're trying to snatch around. They're trying to get some kills onto the B site. Exist is good for one. JKS just needs to stall as long as he can. Liaz is making a move now through the CT side. They're constantly flashing. JW, that's such good teamwork from Renegades. This CT side is looking so slick.
Yeah, they are dominating the bulk of these rounds. Azen, Liaz, and JKS neither have died yet in five rounds played. That is the level of survivability that these guys are having right now. They are tearing it up. Most kills for any player on Fnatic has existed with two and five rounds played, so it has been just an absolute tidal wave from Renegades here. It's also just interesting that they haven't really shown us anything standard yet. Like, they've really just been kind of focusing a lot on middle early. Now they're finally going to go for a little bit of E control, but with CZs, I mean, this is not really going to amount to much, you'd have to imagine.
I wouldn't think so. If the rifles have been yielding nothing, what chance does the CZ and the P250 have? Molotov instantly extinguished. My smoke tossed into mid. All five players off Fnatic coming here, and they're just drawing away Jacob. He's on speedway. JKS has also been smoked out. There is a small gap in that smoke, however. And Jacob nearly capitalizes on it. Does so much damage to exist on the cross. Bomb planted, dink onto Azza. Can count himself lucky he's alive on a measly 1 HP. Can this CZ claim more headshots, though? They're going to need Crims to do so much damage on the approach because everybody for Fnatic are tagged. It's only JW that's relatively healthy. Crims is the next to fall. Still five players alive. Still, somehow, so much carnage, so much injury across the board. But Renegades don't lose a player. We'll be limping out of this round, but it'll be with a 6-0 lead on their back.
Still three players have not died yet. This game for Renegades when we're six rounds deep. This is so brutal for Fnatic. Finally, an AWP comes out. It's going to be on JW. I think it's because Twist has been doing a lot of banana stuff with Exist lately. Brawn actually has gone back to apartments in a lot of these rounds, which is weird because he was playing B a lot for Fnatic earlier this year and very successful at it. But I know, again, apartments is a position that Roland had played in the past on former teams, so he's comfortable in that role. But this is definitely an adjustment to Fnatic's default on T-side Inferno. Even at Sydney, when I was watching them play against, you know, some of the teams there, they still had the roles different than this. So this must be an adjustment kind of coming into these tournaments.
The pressing statistic for Fnatic 2, by the way, is in six rounds, they've only collectively got five kills. Quist, one of their biggest players, one of the players that, you know, has this huge skill ceiling that could touch the sky, 006. Exist actually top fragging on two kills. That goes to show how one-sided this has been and why you're seeing Liaz, JKS, Azza all up there with super huge amounts of money.
Then that's my thing, though. Like, with the T-side struggling, how many reps in official matches has Fnatic really gotten with this position change? Like, this seems really fresh to me. Again, I didn't notice this against Liquid at Sydney in the finals. Those are very recent changes, and they may be going through some teething problems. But here comes a good little entry from Twist up middle. That's going to help things along. Might find another. Indeed, he does. That's Gratisfaction down.
Yeah, Jacob and Liaz. Lonely, isolated from one another, and soon to die. Jacob can't get anything done against JW. Fnatic will get their first round. Finally, they're on the board. Can they build off this, though?
Double op on T-side Inferno, Vince? This is odd. Twist was normally doing it at Sydney in previous events, and JW was playing the apartments. They've had JW opping, and last round he was very effective, but now Twist picks up a second one. Yes, you can kind of peek mid and banana simultaneously with ops and maybe get something going. JKS takes down Twist, though. That's already one off the board. Took a lot of damage to do it in the fire, but made it happen through the flames.
I mean, that's a position where if they did have an AK instead, Twist would almost guaranteed got the kill. The only reason he doesn't is because he gets the one bullet, he misses it, and the rushing player just capitalizes, which was JKS. Additionally, just to make it even more unreasonable, now Renegades can use their two orbs. So you've just gifted across a power play to Renegades. Fnatic, they are struggling to get any kind of cohesive effort together. Credit to Renegades, they're playing this so well, but I feel like Fnatic are shooting themselves in the foot too, to a degree.
Again, I wonder how much the changes are affecting them. I also, again, because they're normally very comfortable at establishing map control, they also have some really good A executes with some good smoke walls up lane and, you know, really crafty stuff. You know, typically a deep playbook on Inferno, but we haven't seen any of that yet. Yeah, they've gotten the one round, sure, but the bulk of this has just been Renegades stomping them, and we'll see if it changes here. They do have a good little mid pressure. They've pushed Azza off. So they've gotten the first stage of A control, but now they have to actually battle their way into the site.
That first box has been ticked, but there are many more that have to fall in line if they want to get this round underway. Flashbang, not going to stop Exist from pouncing. Liaz is in pit. How much damage can he inflict? He does dink Exist partially through the wall, leaving Jacob and JKS a 2-on-3. Did just see a head bobbing up over the boxes, not able to connect onto it. And with that miss, it's going to be a save. So Fnatic are going to string two rounds together. They're starting to bring down that economy that we're talking about. There's still plenty, though, in the bank balance for Renegades, especially if they can save both these guns. But Fnatic starting to show signs of life.
Yeah, that's one of those executes I was talking about. Really good smoke wall on pit to isolate Liaz, not really let him have an impact on the actual take itself. Also had a good smoke on Moto that forced Renegades to kind of push through it, which gave Fnatic a free frag. Good entries from Exist all in all. And so, as you noted, there's finally a little bit of normalcy being established for Fnatic in this. Still not comfortable yet. Still plenty of money for Renegades to buy, considering how many rounds they won in a row and how many times they survive with all five players.
Well, the comeback has commenced. Will it continue to pick up traction, or is this where Renegades adapt, evolve, survive? Smoke into Molotov, JKS aggressive. That grenade's gonna be too deep to really deal with either of them. Only five health taken away. Once this smoke clears, though, JKS may think twice about being in this angle. And yeah, indeed, he's going to start to pull back. There's no need to give his life away for free. You still have a lead. Sure, the momentum is starting to swing back towards the Swedes, but don't give them anything. Free. Make them fight for each inch.
Krims has established a little bit of control towards Boiler. Brolin about to come off the balcony. So everything's okay, but they do not have banana control. JKS is holding it off solo pretty well thus far. Jacob was leaning towards A as the fourth, but now he's retreating back as JKS has gotten forced back into the B-bomb site, no longer has that information on numbers at banana. And we do see Krims and Brolin fading back, so it will be a B attack. They have the smokes for spawn and coffins. They have Molotovs for oranges and new box. They have the flashes. They have everything they could need. And Gratis Faction has not yet begun to shift with that AWP into CT spawn, so they will have, for all intents and purposes, as good as it gets when it comes to the numbers advantage on this B attack.
This is JKS and Jake, who've been holding B very well thus far. Gonna spam through the smoke. Flashbangs connecting. There's a gap in the smoke that Jacob's trying to make the most of. JKS now is able to get one. The Gratis Faction additionally was plucked out from CT spawn. After the hands of Twist, we've made a move into ruins already. And he would have been a big part of pivoting back onto the B side of the map. So, Fnatic, they are keeping Renegades in their sights. They're not letting them escape. They're bringing this back round by round.
Yeah, really efficient trading from Fnatic on that execute. Again, they got a favorable push. No third man had really gotten there to help with the initial attack, and they limit Jacob and JKS to one frag apiece. It's exactly what you need. Just trade one for one. Then, as you noted, picking off Gratis Faction, the first rotator over before he even had a chance to land a single shot. Keeps the 3-on-2 post plant. Renegades forced to take the remaining two just to save the guns. Yeah, there's still plenty of money, but retaking there was going to be too difficult. Would rather just roll those guns over, keep the reserve cash for later, opt back over to Gratis Faction. Plenty of utility and aids going in. So we're starting to see Fnatic settle in. They're starting to get some map control a little bit better. Some of these executes they've been pouring out, the utility usage is starting to get on point. This is exactly more like the Fnatic you're used to seeing on Inferno. A little bit of shock and awe from Renegades early, but now Fnatic are finding their way.
What's a good nade on to Exist? Yeah, it does seem like Renegades have slowed down a little bit with their aggression. Plus, as you said earlier, Fnatic, a lot of it was their own doing. Pushing into mid without flashing, walking into crossfires. Now that they are being a bit more stable, now that they are looking like they're easing their way into Mirage, those mistakes aren't happening. That's a brilliant flash into peak onto Jacob. That's going to force Gratis Faction around towards CT. With loads of time left as well, Dust. I mean, Renegades are going to be spread so thin.
That's a great early kill from Twist. As you noted, it causes them to have to rotate that second player to B, which is two to each site now. It just depends on when Gratis faction decides to go back towards spawn and help cover Arch, because that's wide open now. They have to focus their efforts on lane pit apartments. They have to give up that side. Now, Azza is keeping tabs on Bracket still, so he will see if they start to try to wrap Arch, which gives Gratis faction a little bit more comfortability to just sit towards B. But again, it's the numbers advantage for that Cats. They're going to explode out of apartments with JW's pop flash.
Looking to waterfall. The dam has been built from Azza with the Orc. Wasn't sure about a second player pushing mid, but he's done his job. Now he needs the rest of his team to follow suit. Liaz is being pulled off, flashes, smokes, molotovs, everything. He's not going to have any impact, but his presence alone is worth so much. It allows JKS to come in. That spray transfer is beautiful. Renegade stopped the three-round winning streak. Fnatic back to the drawing board.
And that's the danger of doing the pop flash waterfall out the apartments, is if your flash is not effective, if the CTs are positioned in such a way to where they are not blinded, and it's very hard to blind people with that pop flash from mid, by the way. There's so many spots CTs can play where they will not be impacted. They just get to shoot you while you're in midair, and you're totally vulnerable. There's nothing you can do until you land on the ground, and a couple of those guys were dead before their feet ever touched the stone. And so that's now a seventh round for Renegade after three in a row from Fnatic. Renegades fights back. Big round from them on the defense on lane. Kind of careless from Fnatic, to be honest. It would be better if you just kind of take a right-hand turn and just try to get into the pit rather than trying to jump out towards lane and just kind of giving yourself up.
So even though they've won three rounds in a row, you can see their money. Shot to pieces. Two players on $0 exist $50. So the pressure's back on for Fnatic. Yes, you've had this little three of rounds that can come to an abrupt end with Renegades taking back over again.
And they've been denied banana control early here thanks to some of Renegades' utility deep down banana. So just Twist and JW kind of still sitting towards T stairs. JW the one with the AWP. Again, a little bit different since Swiss was hopping on T-sides on the other maps, but now it's JW, so I guess it's kind of just map-dependent for them right now as they're shuffling through some different role transitions over there. Brolin leading up to the apartments, and it seems like Fnatic aren't sure just yet what they'd like to do. Twist is beginning to try to get some real estate back over towards B. We'll get indeed to the top side. Smoke down, though, so he won't be able to get too much.
They could land on the head of Fnatic. Not quite. Was tossed over by JKS. That's ordnance that won't be available later on. There's not much more for the later on portion of this round, though. We're only on 25 seconds remaining. Three of the five of Renegades positioned on A. One has just been culled. Jacob, a Twist. Oh. Why did you have your knife out? I don't understand that. Jacob's going to go in with JKS. It's starting to fall apart. The bomb still isn't on towards the site side. It hasn't been planted. There's 10 seconds now. Roland and JW can sit in the smoke forever as far as Renegades are concerned, because this round is going to go the way of the CTs. What an odd, chaotic mess of a round that was in the end. Gratis faction is going to try and take the gun away, and JW will be able to hold on to the AK-47. But Dust, what did I just witness?
Well, what the play was is Fnatic did throw a smoke wall on pit, and they actually snuck Brolin into the pit, and they were trying to fake a lane attack. They were trying to pull the B rotation off. They kind of did. Jacob did drift towards spawn and start to rotate A, so they almost got what they wanted, but for whatever reason, they didn't really snap immediately into a B execute. So Jacob just was able to get back to B. I mean, Gratis faction had an AWP peeking lane from Moto and say, hey, there's no one there, guys. Like, they're not attacking. So Jacob just went back, and so the fake didn't really work. The timing wasn't right. They didn't hit B when it was vulnerable. They got stalled out, and then, yeah, they just run through a smoke spawn and die with a knife in his hand. I mean, that's obviously not going to get you anywhere. So they had a great initial approach, but they just didn't capitalize the final steps of it appropriately. They had the roots down, but nothing grew from it.
Like, I understand having a knife if you're trying to make it so that your barrel of a gun isn't sticking through smoke. Right, I get that. But you're walking into a position where if no one is watching CT, there's such a low probability that's the case. And when you've only got 15, 20 seconds left in the round, that is such a ballsy gamble. Like, that can straight up lose you the round. Yeah. They needed manpower at the end. They needed to have presence, but
they also just needed Brolin to have more impact. He did get one kill for today, but again, the problem is that they knew that he was the only one there. Like, it took too long for Brolin to get his kill, and it took too long for Fnatic to hit B. The fake just didn't have the impact it should. Timing wasn't there, and now Fnatic have to do more with less here. Just a couple of pistols, limited utility, a few AKs. They're gonna get, again, a vulnerable B bombsite. Only the two normal defenders here in Jacob and JKS. No rotation just yet.
Flashes in the eyes of the CTs, but they can use that pillar as a sanctuary. It builds a wall ahead of JKS, and he's using this so very well. Jacob with two Molotov kills. Hello, Fnatic. Are you okay? Do I need to call a doctor? I feel like we need some kind of help from Fnatic right now. Please call a timeout, guys. Please. Just do it.
You gotta do better than that, man. There's only two guys on the site. You have five. You gotta at least trade one for one. Maybe they get one extra kill off their great play, but the fact that Jacob sprays one and gets two kills with the flames, I'm not even sure how they got stuck in the fire like that. I mean, they were crossing to pool, which is pretty standard, but you gotta get towards the site to get out of the flames, and they didn't, and that's just free kills for Jacob. You hardly ever see that happen, where an incendiary just burns people down from essentially 0 to 100, and they can't get away from it. Maybe one, but two? That's crazy.
I think that play pretty much sums up this Inferno thus far for the Swedes. They are at least going to get a kill back on short. They exist. Try and put the deagle to use. As it says, no. It is just one by one getting picked off. In this round, of course, it's more understandable as it is just against pistols. Do you have a bomb planted at least? So they've got that going for them. Everything else is stacked against them though. Still plenty of grenades going to be tossed onto the obvious angles of pit and graveyard. Crim's not going to get checked underneath Brolin. Or Jacob, pardon me. It's going to be disappointing for him, but Renegade still can get the round. 10-3.
This is getting a little bit out of hand, Vince. I'm still kind of reeling from that two guys dying from fire around. That still kind of blows my mind. And now just a couple of rounds left to play in this half. And Fnatic, yeah, they got a buy here thanks to that bomb plant, but they've not shown us any sort of consistency. We've seen glimmers of hope. Some of their utility usage on the A bomb site in particular has been quite nice. They've gotten favorable duels on the B bomb site. They've gotten several 5-on-2 executes where no one from Renegades had even budged from the A side. Yet they still can't convert those advantages into anything. Even with good utility down that has at times tricked Renegades and caused them to move around, they, again, have just never capitalized on it.
Molotov up and over towards short. I'm going to try and make the most of that. Solid entry, much more like it from Fnatic. There's two. Jacob, though, flashbang in his eyes, gets two frags. They line up for him. Wasn't far off a third either. JW only on 11 HP. But as Faction's going to take the charge and try and peek around the corner, but the Shadow's going to betray him. Twist storm coming from a mile off. And maybe Fnatic can end this half in winning ways. Five rounds would not be the end of the world. That would give them something to play with.
It's just crazy that JKS and Jake on the B defenders have 31 kills between them. They have absolutely been a brick wall at that B bomb site. In some cases, they really shouldn't have been. Should have been traded out, but they've played so well. I have to give them their props. Good round finally, though, from Fnatic. They controlled middle well. They got a couple of favorable trades. Had a 5-on-3. Jacob caused a bit of sweat to break out across the foreheads, I'm sure, with that little push that got a couple of kills. But at the very least, they were able to navigate their way through it all and find round number 4. All comes down to this final one. Full buys for both teams so they can put their best foots forward. But Renegades has been the dominant force all half long. Can Fnatic punch one more through, though, to stay competitive? Again, both teams facing elimination on this map. Winner moves on to lower bracket finals for a shot at the playoffs.
The loser is going home. Fnatic, thanks a little bit more passively. Gonna sit back on the spawn and hope that Renegades make a few mistakes, but we've already seen that. I've been very disciplined on this CT side. They've had aggression, but it's been controlled. It was never relentless. It was never reckless.
I think the bigger thing, Vince, is the fact that they've been able to just not really need to over-rotate to assist and reinforce. They've been able to rely on their anchors just to do enough every single time. That's crazy that you can do that. That's so, so key.
Fnatic must realize too, as I said before, they do get a fifth round. They're asked the ways back. All of the mistakes, all of the sloppy plays can be forgotten. They have something to aim towards now. Another smoke going to be planted at the top of Banana. The issue here is that they're in no close proximity to getting real estate that they can really execute off quickly. This is going to go down to the wire again. 28 seconds left. Now the bomb is starting to make a move up. They're going to be completely forced on A. How do they get these entries going their way? Krim's going to take the peak, but going to get traded one for one. At least alleviate some of the pressure that was mounting over on the Arch's side. Gratis Faction may think about picking that again, but now he's got onto the site. The bomb's being denied. They don't check the box. This is a problem of not having much time left. You're forced into angles you don't want to be in. Twist is able to get a headshot, but there's no time. Fnatic have tied themselves out. They've tripped over themselves again. And the first half will read 11 Renegades or Fnatic.
That's so tough. That happened again, man. They get good utility on lane. They're isolating pits so nicely. They're even getting control of it. They get a pickup Arch, but they just don't clear the site. And then they run out of time because they stall out for too long. That just happened way too many times, and it cost them so many rounds. Renegades, on the other hand, played the CT side almost to perfection the bulk of the way through. So many good plays. And now they are in the driver's seat towards the lower bracket finals. They're up 11-4. We're going to take a short break. When we come back, we'll bring you this half of the final map of this series, the final half for one of these teams. Stay tuned.
This will be the final half of Counter-Strike that one of these two teams will play at DreamHack Masters Dallas. It's looking more likely it'll be home time for the Swedes, with the boys moving through to another game later today. Roles reversed. Renegades on the T side with 11 rounds. Fnatic 4 on their CT. They need this pistol. It is so vitally important to us. Even if they pick it up, though, it's going to be quite a while before we start to see them realistically challenge Renegades.
So very true. And it would be a tough loss for Fnatic to fall out this fast. They've been consistently kind of placing top four lately. Even made the finals of Sydney. So to fall out in the group stage here in Dallas would be a pretty heavy blow to the trajectory that they've had. But it would get Renegades back on track, perhaps. I know they've had their struggles with stand-in situations for EPL, but they also had really positive movement after the Major. They want to pick back up where they left off with this lineup, and here comes the B attack to try to drive it home against a solo defender in Twitz, who's already so low on health.
Yeah, because he got dinked earlier, he had to pull back and just play retake. They do have a kit and a couple of flashbangs. There are waves back in, but they need Twitz to stay alive. Because right now, they're all coming the same direction. Liaz with a Glock, they're gonna line up in front of each other. It's always dangerous. You could shoot your teammates in the back of the head. Twist has also gone down, so everyone can focus their attention onto Banana now. On the CT side entrance of the site, Brolan gonna get the freebie. No, misses that, but they get the harder of the shots. Comes back in again, and he's not done just yet. He's on a 4K. He wants the ace. He's not gonna get it done, and Jacob spins back out. The heartbreak for Brolan's ace, but more importantly, Fnatic, they're one step out of DreamHack Dallas now.
Man, I have to look at that again, but something kind of just crazy happened. Obviously, Brolan runs out of bullets, has to reload, so he's done, but I don't know what happened to the other player. I think that Prince, did he also run out of bullets? Like he had a knife out in his hand when he died. I'll check back with that in a second, Vince, but that is really, really a tough pill to swallow for the Swedes. That does put Gates so tantalizingly close to the finish of this series.
Ooh, what a time as well for something that chaotic to happen. Fnatic, I thought they had it, you know, when Brolan started to spinning around, landing headshots left and right.
Yeah, I'm looking back.
I thought the cutback was on the tracks. Probably get a chance to watch that dust, because this does seem a little bit slower in terms of the start of the round. Renegades feeling it out. K case, there is some kind of a pistol stack. Obviously, we can see the Fnatic have four sports, so this is another precious situation.
So I was right. Krims also ran out of bullets. So the last two players both ran out of bullets and had to reload. Krims tried to pull out a knife in desperation. That helped finish it off for Renegades. Wow. Obviously, chat already is just seeing it now, but I had obviously streams on a big delay, so that's the only way I could go back and look at it. So apologies for bringing this up really late, but yeah, that was crazy.
JW gets popped. Many more may follow. Good flashbang. Krims, three bullets to his name. Gets slotted by Liaz, who is going to get two in quick succession. Again, this was a force by Fnatic. The Swede put everything into this round. Exist has been dealt a cautionary bullet from Gradus Faction. Will he heed the warning? No. And Liaz isn't playing around. He's not taking any prisoners. 13-4 on an eco round. Fnatic Man. Are so nearly done.
Liaz playing so well, dude. Again, it's crazy to see that he's kind of surpassing guys like Jacob and Azza for rating at this tournament. He's having the best LAN he's probably ever had with Renegades. Again, amongst the top 10 rated players in the tournament so far. Again, it's nice that they have these executes where he can get into the mix, where he doesn't just have to support, where he can kind of get back to maybe what he's used to doing when he used to play within his region, let loose a little bit, flash off some of that skill. And obviously this round, Fnatic have very little to pose with against Renegades, fully saving for the next round. One already on the Mortician's table, Twist very nearby.
Yeah, Twist just took a grenade flush to the head. 76 damage inflicted. Jacob now making a move onto the site. Roland, the only real threat with his P250. Not going to make anything land. So we are going to have a 10-round advantage on the side of Renegades. Fnatic will have a bye, what could be their last goodbye of DreamHack Dallas.
Yeah, it's kind of crazy how the series has played out. Mirage was so intense. Train even had its moments. And now we've kind of gone out with a whimper here so far in Inferno. Of course, the Renegades fans are obviously pretty happy about that, I'd have to imagine. Shoeys and all. You're not quite to the playoffs yet, but you're certainly getting close. Again, they playing that winner of NRG in G2 in the lower bracket finals here at Group B. And that game, G2 and Energy, is also in a map 3 situation. G2 really far out in front, though, on Overpass. 11-3 on their CT side. So that might be wrapping up right around the same time we are, unless Energy can claw their way back. This is Fnatic's last hope, you have to feel. This full buy must do it all, or they are out of the tournament early.
If ever there was a moment for a player to really turn it up a few notches to get a hero play in effect, it has to be now on Fnatic. Three players, a 2B standard play from Fnatic. They're not going to be trying any gimmicky stuff right now. Three incendiaries, four smokes. Plenty of ability to stall and stymie the push. And Renegade's going to go in for the jugular. They can sense the weakness. They can sense the blood in the water. That smoke gives a little bit of a gap twist now. Has to turn tail and run away from Coffins. That is going to become his final resting place of this round. Liaz, again, chipping in with the flashes, chipping in with the assist. Fnatic do have a way forward, though. JW's made a move around the corner of the smoke. There's going to be a Molotov to greet, and that's going to buy up enough time now for Renegades to put their feet in the ground and make their last stand. Liaz taking damage, and he is the last player alive. AK-47 to his name. Two frags alongside with it. Is he about to pull this off? No. A valiant attempt. In fact, he may have actually got this. He has. There's not enough time. Liaz single-handedly has just pulled off the 1v3 clutch.
Did he really have been destroyed again?
Did he really not have time? He had a kit. I don't want to call it because I'm not 100% sure because my audio is a little bit low, so I couldn't hear the timer. And obviously, what you can have like in-game music that kind of lets you know if it's no way, but it looked close, man. It looked like he might have been able to get it.
That's why I was kind of casting that, like he clutched it, but then I realized it's so close. And it may have been one of those like 50-50 calls where he wanted to just make sure he had an M4 left to drop one of his teammates, but...
Maybe someone can tweet at me and tell me if they can like time it out, but I don't have time to go back and count. But yeah, I don't know, that was weird.
It feels like a matter of milliseconds, man.
Yeah, I mean, they did so well in the retake too, as far as actually getting the frags. Like, they had a really good incendiary they threw from construction into the dark corner that flushed a player out. They got some really good kills. Yeah, Liaz, you know, credit to him. He held his ground, got a couple of really key kills to win off the clock, apparently. But yeah, that's so tough because now Fnatic are pretty much halfway out the door already.
Oh man, I just watched that back. I think he did have enough time. I'm sure there was about 5 or 6 seconds between him giving up and the bomb detonating.
Yeah, it's always hard for me to call because I can't know what's going through the player's head and what they're hearing. But yeah, I thought the same. But either way, that's gone now. They have to focus forward on 11 rounds in a row to find an overtime. We can see that Renegades already have so much good map positioning here towards the A side of the map, and they have the man advantage to flex. Krim's trying to battle back. He does the damage, but does not find the frag. And here comes the wrap. Krim still stands firm, but only for one, and JKS and Jacob opening it up.
Twist or exist. It's your time to shine. Your time to pull something special out of the playbook. Playing fairly surreptitiously is Twist, trying to sneak around the side. There's no further time for him to do so. They've got to get on here. They do have a kit. No nades. Raw entry frags back onto the site required. Not going to be happening. Exist, last man standing, not for much longer. And Renegades are going to be victorious. They not Fnatic out. And they will live to play one more best of three, at least at DreamHack Masters Dallas.
Indeed, they will. Congrats to Renegades for staying alive. They will be playing that winner of G2 and Energy a little bit later on this afternoon or this evening, depending on where you're at in the world, for that last playoff spot coming out of Group B. This is Dust with me as Vince. We've been bringing you all three maps this best of three. We got two more BO3s to go, Vince. We get to start promoting some teams to playoffs, but we'll also be sending some teams home along the way. So some positive and some negatives, of course, there. Hope you folks are enjoying the broadcast. If you do, please go ahead and hit X-Men Destroy Cast in chat. Give us a follow if you want. Also, appreciate your feedback. If you want to send it that way on Twitter, we'll take that as well. And yeah, we're going to take a break. When we come back, we'll have Vitality taking on North. It's a rematch from the upper bracket, best of one, where they had a really close game, 16-14 overpass in favor of North. And it's going to be a bit of a grudge match for a playoff spot. So we'll be back in probably about 20-25 minutes is usually how long it takes. So we'll be back shortly to bring you that game. So stay tuned.